Cool. So welcome to this presentation. My name is Laurent Bugnon. I actually work for Microsoft since last year. I'm now what they call a cloud developer advocate, so I'm paid by Azure. And my expertise, or my specialty, if you want, is in .NET and cross-platform programming with Xamarin, especially. I'm more of a client person, so when I climbed on Azure, it was a little bit of a shock for me. Oh my God, everything is in the server. But I did a lot of server-side development before, so that was fun. And I'm not really a web guy. I used to be. I was a web guy in the Visual Interdev times that Richard mentioned before, so that was a long time ago. And then I did a huge web application for my firm back then, Siemens, which was using ASP.NET 1.0. So those were the days. And that was really fun. I mean, I really enjoyed that. I was actually a JavaScript expert in the day. I was talking with Douglas Crockford, that Richard mentioned as well, whom Richard mentioned, in 1995. And those days we had something called Usenet. I don't know if you guys remember. It was news colon slash slash. Just like now we have HTTP colon slash slash, right? So it was another protocol. And Usenet was basically was forums, so you could go and ask questions. And there was one called comp.lang.javascript, computer.language.javascript, where in 94, 95, we were debating about the best ways to do inheritance in JavaScript and how can you make that dynamic language a little bit more static. And those were really fun days. And my very first website was an FAQ, frequently asked question site, where I was answering frequently asked questions from the comp.lang.javascript pages. So my whole history, my first involvement in the community, if you want, comes from JavaScript. And then I found Java, and then I found C Sharp. I did an ASP.NET project, and then I found WPF and XAML, and then I said I will never touch JavaScript ever again if I can avoid it. And the funny thing is that you know, Richard showed the good part, JavaScript the good parts, right? I don't know if you saw this picture already, but there is a definitive guide to JavaScript, which is a book like this thick. And then there is JavaScript the book, the good parts, and it's like this thick, you know? And I mean, literally, it's an interesting language, but yeah. So I'll show you something which allows you to get away from JavaScript a little bit, which is fun.